final play call there, were you with Rozier coming off for a three option there? Was that just, you know, Tavares out reading it?
Yeah, that was something that, you know, he did a great job of cutting, misdirecting, lost his guy. Brogdon jumped out and switched. Morris read it right. And, you know, Morris got up a really good look. Feel really good about that with 5 seconds left in the game. They do so much switching. You know, I thought that our guys, you know, the goal of that is to get both guys on one side. Brogdon did a good job staying under Al. But then you always have the option of going one-on-one there on the other side, nobody there, which is, you know, not the worst thing in the world either.
You guys got stopped with about 35 seconds left, decided to push it. What's the balance there between being aggressive and transition?
55 seconds left?
45, 35.
I think it was a little bit above that. I think you have to attack in transition. You know, I think that ultimately, how many teams you see just hold it? You got a 1-point lead, and then you bleed the clock down and get a terrible shot. I'm all for attacking up the court. There's so many possessions still left. There were 5 possessions left in that game anyways. And, you know, just didn't go our way. But I like that attack. If we lay it up, it's the greatest decision in the world, you know, and I think that that's sometimes is the way you play. I want our guys to play free. I want our guys to attack. And if you have that mentality inside a minute, I think that's a good thing.
Brad, Jalen really carried you in that second half, and just what was his effort like today? Is it one of his best performances ever?
Well, he's the only reason we were in the game in the first. You know, I thought he was great in the first. And then in the second, he just continued it. Did a great job. Played with tremendous spirit, with tremendous toughness, and made shots, kept us in it.
Right, yeah, Gary Washington, Boston Globe. Why the 20-point deficit? What did you guys do in the first 2.5 quarters? And then how tough is it when you do everything right and then Giannis seems to make up for any mistake that they make with tip-ins and play?
Well, we played great in the second half. We played great in the first 6 minutes of the game. 18 minutes that ended the first half, we're not good. And they had a lot to do with that. Again, Maker came in and made a huge difference in this game. And I thought that we were so much better after the break. Even when they made those first few shots, I thought we were doing what we had kind of set out to do.
Steve Lopez, Boston, kind of following up on Harris' question. For the last game here, you guys were talking about how you guys were driving into traffic, and you seem to be a little bit more of that again in that stretch, that 18-minute stretch. How do you guys get away from that, or is it just the human nature?
I think you have to play with tremendous, tremendous poise, and it takes a ton of ability to bounce back and win the next possession and focus on that next possession. But, you know, we got, I thought they got us off kilter and we just started again trying to swing for the fences. We did a great job of not doing that in the second half, though.
Coach Mark D'Amico, Celtics.com. Semi Ojeleye checks in and plays 17 minutes. Not a lot in the box score, but what did you see that he brought to the team tonight?
Switchability and guarding Giannis.
Just to follow up, you went to Al Horford bringing the ball up during the second half. What went into that decision?
I think just a couple of times, right? So it was just an action to run.
Brett, Nick Friedel, ESPN.com. You've been very complimentary, to be honest, throughout the series. What's it like trying to account for him late in the game in the final minutes?
Well, he made a great tip in. You know, that was, and he was battling for the ball, and our guys were battling for the ball, and that's what great players do. You know, and I thought for the most part, we did a decent job on him. You know, probably better than we have in every other game. And he still goes 12 for 20, but we were better on Middleton. I thought we did a decent job on Giannis. And we played the way that we want to play in the second half.
Coach Gabe Stokes, Brewhoop.com. Do you think you guys were able to find more success on the offensive side of the ball in the when Bledsoe was in compared to Dellavedova, especially later on in the game?
They're both really good players.
Coach Amanda Fleegrad, Celtics.com. With this series now tied, what have you said or what will you say to the team before game 5?
This is what it's all about. It's fun. This is a really talented team we're playing. We didn't mistake that when we were up 2-0. I mean, we had to work hard and play tremendous to get that 2-0 lead. So we played really well tonight. There's certain things we can build off of. There's certain things we have to avoid. We can't have those first half, you know, doldrums that we've had the last two games. But at the end of the day, they had a lot to do with it, and they deserve credit for that.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.